wish I could say no, wish I could say no, wish I could say no. But I went too far, I fell too deep, and I lost control. Warn your daughters, tell your sons, before it's too late for an intervention. Hooked like me, chasing that rush, heart strung out, can't say no to love. I said last night was the last
oh, bitches,
time,
but my not willpower quit when I hit the red. I did this look that you see right here. I wanted to do something really different for today's channel, and I kind of like to do, like, if you guys notice, I'll do, like, a bold lip, and I'll do a nude lip, or I'll do, like, a really bright color eye, or I'll do a smoky eye, but I just wanted to do something different, and I definitely use different products for today's look that I haven't used in a really long time, so... Yeah, all this stuff, this is traditional stuff that I use, like, obviously I use the same eyebrow pencil, which I love the Anastasia brow definer. And obviously I use the same mascara, but, like, I use a different bronzer today, I use a different highlight. I actually use a different red lip for today's look. I usually like a more paprika kind of red lip, like Hot Shot. Is really like neon orange, but I use in today's video, I use the Morphe lip color. Get it? Morphe red, Morphe, that's like their traditional color, but it's more of like a true red and a darker red, and it's more blue based, where this has a more orange base, if you understand that. Yeah, but this is definitely a classic red, like Marilyn Monroe would probably wear this red, where this is more 2020 red. This is what my mom would wear, but I wear this because I love it on pale skin, and I get a lot of compliments when I do wear it. People love it. This one is very similar to the Charlotte Tilbury. It's called Hot Emily, which I've used on my channel before, which you guys love. That's when I wear that, and other people love it when I wear that. But yeah, I have to say my man really loves when I wear red. Loves, like, I don't know, whenever I post a selfie with a red lip, he loves it. I don't know, he thinks it's like sexy, but I've never really liked red lips on myself, but as I get older, I'm kind of in it. I'm with it. You know, you just gotta get, like, you have to wear it a lot of times. Like, if you feel uncomfortable and it's not for you, wear it a few times. Trust me, like, the more you wear it, the more you love it. And, like, a lot of people will compliment you. It's just very classic. Yeah, and traditional. It's definitely, like, you have to have a bold personality to wear a bold lip, which I do. I have to say my mom, she's out there, and she loves a banging red lip. I have to say she's worn, like, kind of pinky purpley, like lip colors, and I told her I don't like it. I like the red on her. That's like her thing, and she loves it. So she's Vietnamese. All Vietnamese women love like bold, like red is a lucky color for them. But yeah, I don't know, like the more as I get older and the more I experiment with makeup, the more I love it. Yeah, it's a little chapped here, but I'm gonna take my makeup off soon. Yeah, like I just, it's such a classic look. Especially with this eye makeup look, I did a kind of like smoky, sultry eye, and I love it. Like, I would wear this for Valentine's Day, Christmas time, for sure, because a classic red, and I would definitely wear this at a, like a staff party, or I would wear this on a date, but I don't usually, like, if I go on a date, I don't like to wear lipstick, because if I know I'm going to kiss the guy, I won't. Like, trust me, because my boyfriend kissed me on the first date. Like, he literally took my breath away. We were making out. If I had lipstick, if I had this lip, we couldn't make out. But that's just my personal opinion. I would wear this, like, on a girl's night out, because I'm going to make out with my girlfriends, let's be honest. But I love it. I love it, like, the way it looks on my skin tone. This is my new favorite favorite red lip. I did buy it a few months ago, and I haven't worn it yet, but I love it. I'm into it. For tomorrow's video, I was going to do a sunset ombre smoky eye, something different, maybe add a wing liner, you know, do something different, do a nude. But the video after that, I want to use, hold on, where are you, honey?
my God.
Oh, here. I have so many lipsticks. It's, like, crazy. I wanted to use, like, so this red lipstick I mentioned when I was started to play with bold red lipsticks in my channel. I mentioned, I did, like, a hand swatch in one of my intros or outros, and I mentioned to you guys that when I watched the 50 Shades of Grey movie, Anastasia, whatever her freaking name is, who's married to Christian, bitch, she wore this red lip color, and I looked it up. There's a few of them she wears from MAC, but this is the one that she loved. I think Cherry is the lip liner that she wore, but this is the actual base of the red lip, and it's called Feel So Grand, and it looks so beautiful on screen on her, especially because Dakota Johnson, she's really pale, so I loved that it looks so good on her skin tone, and it literally looked like red velvet on her lips, and I was like, bitch, I need it, and this is Feel So Grand. This is probably one of their top sellers at MAC, and I really do love the formula. I haven't used this yet on my channel, but I will. I think I want to do kind of like a gold glitter kind of smoky eye with this red lip, like something different, and then I'm going to use this. And whenever I do a bold lip, I don't like to use the same thing over again, because I want you guys to experience different products. Yeah, like, I mean, every lip product is different. Like, the Morphe one I really love, the YSL one was really different that I did the other day. This is really different. Like, not everyone's going to like the same lip product. So I always like to be very versatile, especially with really bold colors, especially a red lip, because, you know, everyone's not going to like the same thing. There's always different finishes. There's the satin finish. Some people just like a matte finish. Some people like a glossy finish. So everyone is different. But if you're just like me and that bitch that likes every different finish on the planet, then you're on the right channel. I'm just saying, but I will use this in a tutorial, and I actually really do love their formula. It's such a beautiful formula, applies on very thin, and it has a lot of pigmentation, and I love the doe foot applicator. It's really easy to apply if you guys don't apply lip liner, but I have to because I'm a hot mess. Let's be honest. Anyways, you guys, I'm super excited for that for my next few videos. I don't have to go back to work till the 19th, so I'm gonna film like a motherfucker, let me tell you. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this tutorial for you guys. It's around 8-9 o'clock right now because I did talk to my mom for a few hours. We were just talking about work and like what we have to do to get ready for the big opening when we go back to work. I don't have to start till 10, but right now I'm not going to the gym, so hopefully I don't have to wake up too early. It takes me an hour and a half to do my makeup in the morning. Like, I won't do my hair, I'll do it at work, but we'll see. Hopefully it won't be crazy busy, but I don't think a lot of people are going to come in just because they're so scared of the virus, but whatever. If you guys do this look, feel free to tag me, message me. I love it when you guys message me or even comment on my channel. I love interacting with my subscribers. You guys are so awesome. I love you all. You guys, honestly, like, you like always say the nicest things to me. I've never had a bad situation with a subscriber, like, or saying nasty things, but my boyfriend told me, like, don't listen to the haters, which I don't. But honestly, like, you guys are so sweet, so nice, so amazing. I love you guys so much. I've never had such a positive feedback, and I've honestly, like, my experience on YouTube has been amazing. Everyone's just super nice and sweet and always calling me pretty, which I don't think I'm the most beautiful girl in the world, but my boyfriend thinks I'm crazy. He's like, you're tripping, like, you're so gorgeous. But he also tells me I'm probably the prettiest girl he's ever been with. So you know when he's a keeper when he says that, which I've seen his ex-girlfriends. I have to say, I'm prettier than them, but I don't really like talking about that. But I'm not overly cocky. And my mom's always, both my parents actually always told me, like, it's good to be beautiful inside and out, but never be overly cocky. Like, I don't tell everyone, oh yeah, I'm so beautiful. I'm just not that girl. Also, I'm not from Vancouver, which I find a lot of Vancouver girls, I'm not saying all of them, they're very cocky. Like, they're like, I only want a man because I need to see what he brings to the table. Like, bitch, what the fuck do you bring to the table? Like, who are you? Like, I think a relationship is a two-way street. Like, you know, you need you guys both need to provide and bring the money and cook and clean. Like, that's what I think a relationship is, 50-50. That's how it should be. I never think that, oh, the man needs to do this, do this, do this. I just think a lot of people in Vancouver are very self-entitled. Like, even though I live here, I'm not from here. I'm from Victoria. And also my boyfriend, he's not from here. I think that's what made me so attracted to him. The fact that he's not from Vancouver, because I find a lot of Vancouver guys, and they're freaking players. And also my boyfriend's from Winnipeg. He has, I don't know, he's very humble, just like me. And it's good to be humble, because I find people like you because of that reason. Anyways, I'm babbling. I love you guys so much. If you haven't subscribed, please do. Or you guys won't know about my updates or any of my videos. I love you guys so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Hey, you guys, welcome back. I feel so good. It's about 5:30-ish. I don't know why. I feel so tired today. I didn't sleep last night. I'm just going to add this Kopari lip glossy because my lips are so dry like a motherfucker. Oh, yeah. It feels so good. It smells good.
So, today I'm going to do a soft, flirty, romantic tutorial, basically. I was going to do this for a Valentine's Day tutorial, but I thought, while I have the time right now, I want to do it right now, today, because when I go back to work, I won't have time to film for you guys as often as I do right now, so why not do it now? Okay, so, after I, applied the foundation, concealer, powder. I basically, it's like my skin looks pretty good right now, but I want to do, I want to like melt in my skin because I'm so dry and it's so hot right now. Whenever the weather changes, my skin is a hot situation. So I'm just going to go in with the Morphe continuous setting mist. I'm just going to spray this all over the face. This is just going to rehydrate the whole face and basically melt any cakiness into the skin. And I always do this, especially because it's so hot. This is just like a relaxing thing. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that feels so hydrating. It smells like cucumber. It smells like spa in a bottle. I love it. And, like, my skin's just, like, really hydrated and dewy. I'm ready for the eyeshadow game. So, I'm going to go in with the Jaclyn Hill palette from Morphe. I love this palette. And I think I'm going to use the shade Silk Cream. Just, why not, you know, because I'm up in this bitch. Okay, what brush do I want to use? I think I'm going to use this brush. This is the Morphe R37, and we're just going to go in with that Silk Cream shade. Like that. I know there's not a lot of powder left in here, but I'm going to basically get what I can. Okay, so just tap the excess off. I just need to place this right in the crease area. And I like to do eyeshadow first before I do the rest of my face lately, just because I can be really messy when I apply under eye powder, and then I don't have to redo my contour or bronzer. You know? Especially like when I'm in a hurry. This look isn't going to be like super, super hard. It's pretty much like very similar to a lot of looks I do here on my channel. But yeah, it's a pretty simple look. But it's like always my go-to look when I want to like add a smoky eye, but not actually doing a full smoky eye. And we'll see. I look really pale today. Like, what's going on? It could be the lighting too. I usually have a ring light just above my tripod, and I usually like a cooler light. I don't really like a warmer light. I find like, especially my shade right now, I'm so pale. I want a really, like, nice, cool shade. And we are going to put some shimmer and glitter on the lid, so you don't really have to focus placing the transition color on the actual crease. Little trick, but whatever. Okay, we're just going to continue with that R37 in that silk cream color. I'm just going to extend it. So I want a cat eye look, basically. If that makes sense. And if it's too high, don't worry. We can fix it up with eyebrow concealer after. Okay, perfect. And then I'm going to go in with the M441. And I'm going to use the shade Pukey. And just tap just really gently. So this is more like a long hair denser brush, and I want to apply a darker shadow just below that, and this brush is perfect. So just, my hair is like in the way, so just in the outer corner area. Can't even talk, you guys. This brush is perfect to apply darker colors in the inner corner. It just gets right in tight in there. And then you can like take that brush and kind of bring it higher. You want it like really blended. This step. Okay, now we're going to grab this kind of definer guide. This is the Morphe 432. This is like one of my go-tos. I always use this. Like, I always have two in my collection just in case, because I like to use this brush for shaping my eyebrows and also applying shadow on my lash line. So we're going to go in with Central Park. It's this really beautiful, neutral, dark brown color. It's not too warm. It's not too, like, red. It's, like, the perfect neutral brown. So we're just going to dip like this. Okay. And then tap the excess off. And then just, we're going to basically stamp on the lash line. If that makes sense. I've done this a few times on my channel before. It's like, if I don't want to do a wing liner and I just want to do a straight liner, but I can't do a straight liner with gel liner, so I'll do this step all the time. But it's just also like, it adds a smoky effect. Okay, just stamp it. And it's literally so easy. Like, you just stamp. Okay, now that we stamp that, not adding extra shadow, we're just going to basically use that brush to flick it out. We're going to make, like, a thick line. If that makes sense. You don't want to add more brown, because then it'll be too, like, smoky, and we can't go back from this. I'm just going to add more, just to make it a little bit darker. And don't forget the inner corner. Like that, and then just flick it out. And this is what's going to give you that smoky effect. Perfect. Now we're going to do the other eye. See, like, what a difference that makes, especially because we added that lighter transition color to give you that lifted effect. It just looks like a really pretty cat eye. Don't worry, we're not done. Okay, perfect. It's a little choppy, but we're going to go back and fix it. Don't worry. I'm going to grab the MAC 242 brush. I love this brush for packing any glitter or shimmer or whatever. And then for shimmer, I think I want to go in with a little bit of a champagne. I'm going to go in with Obsess and SBN because this one's a little too champagne and this one's a little too bronzy gold. And I always mix them together. They're really pretty together. They're like, if I want like kind of like a champagne lid, I always mix these two together. So beautiful. Like, it's literally the perfect champagne color. And I'm just going to spray my brush because I always spray my brush with any kind of setting spray, Matte Fix Plus. It just makes the shimmer really pop and metallic. And you guys know I love to be a metallic bitch. Okay, we're just going to place those all over the lid. Just on top of that kind of brown. We're going to go back in with the brown. I just want to place this all over the lid. You just want to be really pretty and dainty and girly. I don't know what kind of blush I want to use. I think I'm going to use like a kind of pinky, coral, girly blush. We'll see how I feel. I just place this all over the lid, like that. Do the other eye. Okay, now that we have that shimmer on there, we're just going to go back in with the brown because when we apply that shimmer, I kind of lost it. So we're just going to go back in with that Morphe 432. We're just going to go back in with Central Park, that neutral brown shade. We're just going to basically just apply some of that brown to the lash line. Just stamping. Because it totally covered it up, and I don't want it covered up. The reason we're doing this to add a smoky effect, and I don't want to lose that smoky effect with all the shimmer we applied, if that makes sense. I know it's a high maintenance eye look, but I always do this. I always go back and forth to make my eye, my eye look what I want it to. So we're gonna add some more there, and then we're not adding extra product, and then we're just gonna like flick it a little bit because we want like a cat kind of smokiness. I've done this look before, but not adding shimmer, but I just wanted to show you guys like how I add the shimmer with adding this smoky effect. Yeah. I feel like I can't breathe. God, if I get the coronavirus, I will literally die. I don't know. I'm like not really ready to go back to work. There's still cases, so I don't understand why they're making salons open. Like, what's the point in people coming to get services done when you're just gonna make them wear a mask and they can't even get half the services done anyways? Like, I don't understand that. Just so, like, the people that work for the government can have their hair cut, that's ridiculous. Even my mom was like, why are they making us come back to work? There's still cases. And we're, like, more at risk. than anyone. Like, when you do someone's color, you're close to them. And they're saying, like, oh, you can't use a blow dryer because it's going to spread germs. You can't do beard trims. You can't, like, what's the point in opening? Like, why don't you just wait till it's actually over so everyone can get stuff done? I don't know. I think it's the government. They're just stupid. Okay, now I just want the outer corner to be really, really smoky. So I'm going to use this itty bitty guy. This is the Morphe 506. I love this brush. Just adding color in the outer corner. It's perfect. We're just going to go back in with that central part color, that neutral brown espresso shade. Just tapping a little in the brush. And we're just going to like wiggle it lightly in that pocket of the outer corner. This is just going to, like, make it really smoky. And just kind of, like, slowly brush it out. Yeah, even the beauty supply store, I wanted to go to one of the beauty, I needed more Davinus hair products. And I was going to go, and I called them. They're like, well, we're not open yet. It's like, well, if the salons are open, how are we going to have, like, color and, like, hair products if the beauty supply isn't open? Like, I don't get it. Stuff that frustrates me. Like, alcohol went up 200%. Like, the prices has gone crazy over, like, certain products. I don't know. I just think it's mad. I'm just like bringing it in the middle of the eye. Okay, and then I'm gonna grab this R37 brush and we're gonna go in with Silk Cream and Pinky just to blend that darkness in the outer corner because I don't want any harsh lines. Just this and just bring it in this outer corner. That makes sense. Yeah. So pretty. Okay, we're gonna do the other eye. See, that just totally makes a difference. And that just took that look to that smokiness. I love. This to be really smoky. Okay, now we're just gonna grab that M432. We're just gonna grab a Central Park again. We're just gonna deepen that lash line because when we flipped it out and apply that darker in the outer corner, we kind of lost that shadow of liner. We're just gonna stamp. I want to define line because this is going to look like we have liner without actually doing liner, if that makes sense. It's just going to add to the smokiness. And, like, I'm more worried about the smokiness than the shimmer. Yeah, because this is more of a kind of romantic, sultry, a smoky eye, if you will. Usually, like, I'm more worried about the glitter, but today it's the smokiness. So just stamping. You're done. That's why. Just saying. Just like that, yeah. I'm just going to use my beauty sponge and just spray some setting spray because that Fenty powder definitely made my under eye dry, and I don't want to be dry. So I'm just tapping it on the under eye just to add some hydration. You know my fear about being dry. I have nightmares about it, I tell you. Can you imagine your whole face was like peeling and dry? Ugh. So scary. And then I wake up, I'm like, what's wrong with you? How come we have dreams like that? Okay, we're going to do our under eye a little bit different. I'm just going to use the same brush because why not? This is the M432. And I'm just going to go in with Central Park again. This is a super easy eye look. Tap the excess. And then we're just going to basically apply this on the lower lash line. I'm just stopping at where the lashes end. Just like that. And then we're going to grab this pencil brush. This is the Morphe from the Rose Gold collection. This is the R41. I love this brush. And we're just going to go in with Silk Cream and Pukey. We're just going to blend that dark brown out. Just because. Yeah. Okay, we're just going to grab this Kylie brush, and I'm just going to go in with that Silk Cream color and Pukey. We're just going to make it more blown out, because this is not as blown out as I would like it. And if you're going to do a smoky eyelid, you might as well just go smoky and make it really blown out. You know? And I am doing a red lip today, just to be even more romantic. I'm going to do a nude, but I did a nude yesterday. Yes. Okay, I'm just going to put this palette away. Yes, I am. I think, what do I want to do next? My head is so itchy. Okay, we're just going to go in with that Fenty Lavender powder again. We're just going to basically perfect the lower lash line. Okay, now we're going to use the Urban Decay 24/7 Waterline Eye Pencil in the shade Walk of Shame. These are the two shades. I find with a lot of cream eyeliners, they're not super pigmented, so I always use two of them because it kind of makes it pop up more. Because I don't want it, I want this, the waterline to pop, but I don't want it to pop too much because I want the main focus to be the smoky eye, if that makes sense. I have to burp, you guys. Sorry. Maybe that's why my stomach hurts. Yo. Okay, now I'm just gonna remove that powder away. I know this is watering. There's a lot of staying power, and it's just a little too cakey for me. Okay, I'm just going to go in. We're going to do under eye powder now. I'm going to go in with the Kat Von D Shaded Nights palette. I'm just going to place this under the eye. And I'm using the Morphe Y11. This is from their, not Rose Gold, their Gold collection. It's because I'm using the Rose Gold collection too. And then I have the Gold one, which I love that line. I'm just going to tap this right under the eye. Oh, shit. I forgot to place, brow highlight. I'll do it after this. I'm just going to use this one. This is the Makeup Forever Star Lips Powder in the shade 13 Ivory. I've been loving using this powder as my brow highlight. It's just so intense. It's my vibe recently. And I'm just going to go in with the Morphe 213. And I'm just going to tap into the cap and just apply this to the brow bone. the look of that highlight. That's another level, that highlight. Okay, we're just gonna put this away. And I'm gonna do inner corner. Okay, I'm just gonna go in with this Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette. This is in 001 Universal. I've been loving this for my inner corner highlight. So I'm gonna use this strobe gold and strobe white just in my inner corner. I'm gonna use this bullet guide. This is the Morphe 455. So we're gonna go in the gold first and spray my brush. I've been loving these powders for inner corner highlight. Like that. Oh yeah. Wait till we put the white. Bitch. Yeah, that's freaking beautiful, yo. Okay, that's looking real good. I think we're gonna move on to lashes now. I'm just gonna apply some mascara. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise in Black is Black. This is my favorite mascara of all time. I'm gonna do a light coat of mascara. Lift lashes in Intoxicating. They're my favorite lashes of all time. I just love them so much. If you guys don't like the drama, you guys don't have to use this, but they're my favorite, so I'm gonna use this. And if you don't like it, just skip this part of the video then. Just saying. Okay, we're gonna just see how this looks. I always like to do this just to see. Yeah, that's really pretty, you guys. It's just so sultry, sexy. Oh, I love it. I love! Okay, we're just going to apply some lash glue. I'm using the Dewy. Did I say Dewy? The Dewy. I love this glue. Ooh, it's like my favorite. And it lasts, oh, I just like squirted a bunch of like lash glue. I find this is like the longest lasting one. I have used other ones like I think it's Kiss Me. Like, I like their lashes, but their lash glue sucks. Like, and if it's clear, it's not good. Like, trust me. I used to use the Revlon one. I would put it on and my lashes would come off. It's just not good. The best one is Dewy. And it's pretty affordable. It's like $12 or $9 for a big tube. And you don't need a lot of it. Okay. We're just going to let that baby dry for 60 seconds. She's definitely wet, but it'll dry. Just like that. Just let her dry. If it's wet like this, just let it dry. It'll dry clear. Same as we did as the right eye. I don't know if you guys can see. I just want you guys to see what I'm doing. Like, as long as you don't get tears in the actual lashes and glue, you should be fine. But usually, like, I'll stop my eyes from watering, and then I'll water after. Okay, I'm going to do contour. Yeah, it's really hard to open them. I think because it's still wet a little bit. Okay, we're just going to grab the Kat Von D Shade and Light Palette. We're going to grab these two contour shades. And then what? I'm going to use this contour brush from Morphe, this queen of a goat hair. This is Morphe M530. I love this brush. It just adds the contour like really precisely. I'm with it. If that makes sense. I just love adding contour and bronzer. Just like adds so much warmth to the face. It totally makes a difference. But I'm a deep sleeper, but he snores. I have to fall asleep before him. And sometimes I'm like, babe, you're snoring. But it's like when he's sitting up. And a lot of my girlfriends have the same problem. Like all their boyfriends are the same. I think it's like if you're sitting up, like your head is leaned back and it's your nose, like you're snoring. But if he sleeps on his side, he doesn't snore. But like, it doesn't really bother me because I can sleep through anything, trust me. Like, I remember I was born, my mom said I slept straight for 2 weeks. She even called the doctor, like, is my child dead? Like, and I was 2 weeks late, like, I didn't want to come out. And they forced me, and my mom's like, well, explains why you love sleep so much. I was like, it really does, because I need my 10 hours, at least. Okay, we're going to do bronzer. Oh my god, I almost like took the whole thing out. Okay. I think I'm gonna use a different bronzer today because I'm feeling, you know, I'm just changing up in here, y'all. Okay, I'm gonna use a different brush. I'm gonna use, this is from the Morphe Rose Gold collection. This is the Morphe R2. I love this bronzer brush. It's so perfect. It's one of my favorites. And yeah, I'm going to use this. This is the NARS bronzer in Laguna. I used to be so loyal to this bitch right here. But as my makeup skills has progressed over the years, I prefer more of a matte. But because we did a really romantic kind of look, I want to do like not a complete matte bronzer. And this is a really pretty bronzer. Or even the Makeup Forever one, the 25i, because it's iridescent. This color is going to be really perfect for this eye look because we kind of did like a shimmer, like a soft shimmer eye look. So I kind of want a soft shimmer cheek color. Also, what's similar to this would be the Physicians Formula. It's called Sunset Bronzer. It has a light shimmer as well. I wanted to buy the Charlotte Tilbury. It's the Glow and Sculpt Duo. It's like $80. But I'm not buying anything right now. I was going to buy it, but I know it wouldn't be coming till like a long time. Especially with the virus going on. I think like everything like is backed up right now because it's, yeah, because one of the clients, she works for the post office. She sometimes is in the area. She told me she's still working, but like a lot of them are working overtime because a lot of people that did have the virus, they're taking time off. But yeah, that's it for my rant. So we're just going to put this on the cheek. I used to only use this bronzer. Like I was obsessed. And MAC, what's it called? Refined Gold. That one's a little more shimmery than this one. But I like, yeah, I like it because it gives you a little bit of a soft glow. It's just different than what I usually use because, I don't know, like, I've been, like, loyal to just MAC bronzers. I kind of like this one because it's not overly shimmery. It just has a light shimmer, beauty sponge. And MAC is always a favorite, of course. I'm just going to contour the nose using this Laguna bronzer. It is shimmery, but I don't care. It'll just add a glow to the face. Actually, I don't like shimmery bronzers as my nose contour, but I kept this look really glowy and bronzy, so this is what I'm doing. I'm just using this Kylie Goat Hair Brush. See? I actually forgot how much I love this bronzer. Bitch, what's wrong with me? I just use other ones. I don't know. I kind of like soft and subtle at the same time. Okay, we're just going to put that away. Bye-bye, NARS. Okay. And then I'm just going to take this nose contour off. Should I do it now or later? Yeah, I'm going to do it now. So I still want to leave that bottom bakage for a while. So, oh, wow. Want to leave it on for a while. Okay. Not good at singing. We're just going to tap some of that setting spray and beauty sponge because that nose powder was on for a while. And we don't want... My nose is quite dry, kind of dry combo. So, I always like to spray setting spray with the beauty sponge just to rehydrate it. And upper lip. Forehead. Okay, and then I'm just going to grab the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, or I'm just going to highlight the nose, upper lip, and chin while that bakage is still sitting on the bottom of the face. I'm just going to grab these two highlighting shades. I know they're empty, but there's still some in there, so I just put the tip of the brush in there. That's what she said. Okay, and then we're gonna use the beauty sponge, the clean side of the tip, spray some setting spray, and just tap that on the bottom of the face. I know we didn't leave that powder on the jawline for that long, but I always do this. Wherever I add loose setting powder, I always like kind of want to reassure that it's not cakey. Just that. You know, y'all. Okay, now we're going to grab that Shade and Light palette from Kat Von D. And again, we're going to go in with these two highlighting shades. We're just going to highlight the jawline. Just makes such a difference to the face. Okay, we're gonna do blush. What blush do I wanna use? Okay, I think I'm gonna go in with the NARS blush. This is the mini one, because I have the bigger one, but since I reorganized my makeup, I can't find anything. But this is the NARS Orgasm one. I got this from a birthday at Sephora, and I don't know if this is true or not. I think they got rid of, like, Super Orgasm, but this is just regular Orgasm. And, bitch, I want a Super Orgasm, because who doesn't love an orgasm, let's be real. Just kidding. Yeah, I love NARS. They have like all their makeup, like they'll name something. It's all related to sex. Like they have, I think it's like this pencil liner. It's called Sex Machine. And then there's another one called like Throttle. Yeah, they're all related to sex. But I mean, that's what NARS is for. Yeah, so this is Orgasm, their blush. I love their blush. And look, it has a little mirror. So cute. Just going in with the Morphe Y4. I'm just gonna basically, I want like a really kind of shimmery coral blush. NARS was known for this Orgasm blush because it was the perfect shade for every complexion. And I think a lot of lines started coming out with more versatile kind of blushes that suited a lot of different skin tones. Because back in the day, before makeup was a big thing, they didn't have a lot of like shade range for darker complexions. And now, like Rihanna created Fenty Beauty because she is a darker complexion. She's from the Bahamas. Or she's Bohemian or whatever. you know, and she is darker skin tone, and she wanted to have a line that represented all skin tones. Like, if you notice, like, she has on her line, like, she'll have, like, a lavender powder for really fair skin, and then she has kind of, like, a caramel darker powder for really darker skin. So she wanted a line to basically represent all different skin tones, and I love that idea. So it's so hard to find, like, a certain foundation for that represents a lot of different skin tones. Like, Too Faced, they just started coming out with more shades of the Born This Way foundation. Yeah, and I love that. And I know Kylie Cosmetics came out with, like, her concealers, and I love the shade range, and people love that because you want to be versatile, especially, like, someone like me or someone like Jaclyn Hill. I know she tans a lot and does self-tanner, and we always fluctuate our skin tone. So you want a line, like, if you love a foundation, obviously you want them to have different shades if you're darker or if you're more pale. But I find with bougier brands, they don't do that. Like Dior, their shade range isn't that great. It's a lot of pale. Like, I don't want to say they're racist, but a little bit. Yeah, with bougier brands, I find they don't have a huge shade range. Like, La Mer is known for that. Like, I think their foundation has three shades. Like, you know, and Charlotte Tilbury, she doesn't have, like, really dark shade. She has a little dark. Like, if you're Hispanic, you could totally suit that. But if you're, like, African, there's not a powder for you that you could wear, kind of thing. Yeah, that's, like, the only thing you have to think about. So if you are a darker girl and you can't find a certain color or foundation or powder, don't go for the bougier brands, because they do tend, I don't want to say they're racist, but they kind of, their target is more the medium light shade, if that makes sense. That's just my honest opinion as a makeup lover. That's my opinion, to be honest. And it's true. Like, it is. It's true. Like, the Forever Skin foundation that I love so much, all their shades are very pink. Like, it's not, like, my mom has a very olive undertone for skin. Like, I find Dior, their foundations are more on the pink side, and there's some yellow shades. There's not really one for, like, darker tones, if that makes sense. Oh my god, I love this blush. It's so pinky and girly. I love it. But yeah, that's my honest opinion. So if you're a girl and you can't find a foundation, don't buy a bougie brand. Buy something like Too Faced. They're probably known for that. Fenty Beauty, of course. What else? I know Lawless Cosmetics, she's known for, like, she's a fair girl, but she also does stuff like that. Natasha Denona, like, she has the whole contour kit that she's, like, really, her stuff is expensive, but it's good. She kind of is known for that as well. I don't know who else. Yeah, that's good. Sorry, I just had to go on a rant. Hourglass is known for a lot of shade range. The Vanish Stick Foundation that I love so much, they have a good shade range, I have to be honest. Okay, we're going to go in with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder and Luminous. Like, this is my favorite powder. I just want to add, like, really flirty kind of glow, and this powder is perfect. I'm just using the M500 from Morphe. I love this powder. I'm just going to add it to the apples of the cheeks, just to diffuse the blush and add, like, an extra glow, because this is a really soft, girly makeup look, if that makes sense. Some continuous setting this before we apply actual highlight. Oh yeah, bitch. Yes! Okay, I'm just going to take my fan and go like this. I don't know what highlight I want to use. Something different for today's look, because I'm just that bitch. You know? You know? Okay. It's so hot in here. My fan even seems hot. It's just crazy. Okay, for highlights, I want to use a different highlight. Just because think I'm gonna use 3 highlights because I'm just that bitch. And be real honest. What is this? This moonstone. No. Okay, I'm gonna use this one. This is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Press Highlighter in the shade Opal. It's like this really pretty golden color. And I'm gonna use this one. This is the Morphe times Jeffree Star JS4. I haven't used this one a lot, but this is my vibe. Yes, and I think because we did kind of like a champagne shimmer on the eye, I think this will be really pretty with this eye look. Oh yeah, that's beaming, bitch. That's beaming. That's good. I think I'm going to add some champagne pop. Oh, yeah. I'm going to use a sponge for the moonstone one. How could I forget? I'm, like, talking so much. So we're just going to dip in the sponge really lightly. We're just going to tap on the cheeks. Just because I love, like, using the sponge for the second highlight. I don't like to do it on the last one. I kind of think it's too much. And then I'll add another highlight after this. Oh yeah, that's... Yes! The highlight is beaming from the heavens! Okay, and I just have to go in with champagne pop because I love using champagne pop because it has such beautiful peachy undertones. Like, yes! And I love Jaclyn Hill. She's like my idol. So this is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Press Highlighter in Champagne Pop. I remember I broke this and I was so mad I broke it because it's so expensive. I didn't want to like reuse it. And then my girlfriend was like, you should. And I was like, okay, I have to say it is a good highlight. What was my big issue? So I'm just going to add to the high points of the cheek. Just a little champagne popping. Yeah. See, that's just beaming. That's another level, yo. Lip color. This is the Morphe color pencil in the shade High Maintenance. It's like this really intense orangey red. I do have a red, but I just love Morphe lip pencils. They're the bomb. They're the bomb.com. Okay, I'm just gonna outline the lip. Okay, fan, you need to fuck off. Perfect. What lip color do I want to use? I think I'm not going to use Hot Shot today because I always use that color. I'm going to use, this is the Morphe liquid lip in the shade Morphe. Get it? Morphe red? Morphe? Get it? Okay, whatever. But this is like their logo is red and it's like a true red color. And I love it. It's like different. And I do love their liquid lips because it's really hydrating and it's not overly dry. Okay, I'm just gonna apply this everywhere. This is like a true red, where like Hot Shot is more like a paprika. Just saying. I haven't done a bold lip in a while. I forgot I have to be perfect. I Yeah, it's like a true red, like a blue red, and I never do this kind of red. I'm kind of into it. Okay, we're just going to seal the deal one more time with this baby. This is the Morphe Continuous Settings Mist. I think I opened my eye too fast. But whatever. Yeah, I'm kind of living for this lip color. It's like very old school Hollywood. I feel like Marilyn Monroe. Yes. I'm a little too excited. Okay, I'm just going to seal the deal. Applying some brow gel. I'm just using the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. It's my favorite, y'all! Now, I'm going to apply some lower lash mascara. This is the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash Mascara. Such a long name for a freaking mascara, but it's my favorite for the lower lashes. Girl. Okay, I think that's good. I'm just gonna curl my hair real quick. I'll be right back, y'all.
Hey guys, sorry, I'm just filming this outro and intro really late. I had to call my mom really quickly, and she was actually really nice to me, which surprised. Whenever she calls me baby, I know there's something, or baby girl, it's like, bitch, why are you being so nice? Or her and I all. We call each other bitch, but I actually really miss her, working with her. Yeah, she told me definitely we are opening on the 19th, as the government said, but she said, like, I think the max people is, like, 20 people, which, whenever we have clients in the salon, it's nowhere more than that. We have about 10 hairdressers, doing clients, so it's no more than maybe like 15 people in the salon, so I think it should be good. But I'm kind of excited to go back to work, to get back in my routine. I still gotta go to bed early. When I used to like go to work all the time, like be there at 10, I used to go to bed at like midnight and I still got up. But I'm not going to the gym in the morning, so I don't really have to go to bed early. But that's not till the 19th. I think a lot of people are opening on the 15th, 16th. But I told her I think you should open on the 19th just so we can prepare. And her and I are going to clean the salon, kind of prepare for everything, and kind of set everything up. I just think it's going to be really weird. When everyone's wearing masks. But anyways, you guys, I had so much fun doing this tutorial. This was actually like a more simple look that I did. I did kind of like, that's what soft and flirty looks are. Like, I kind of did a more simple smoky eye. And I love doing like a sultry smoky eye with a red lip. I think it complements really well. And this smoky kind of sultry eye isn't too smoky. So you could definitely do a red lip with it. And I just wanted to do a really romantic look. Like, very like soft, flirty, and girly. And I love it. I actually really like this red lip. I don't know, I'm kind of experimenting with different red lips. I usually like a more intense hot red, like the color Hot Shot, or like even the YSL one that I used yesterday was really pretty. I want to use the MAC Retro Matte Liquid Lip in Feel So Grand. I haven't used that one on my channel yet, and I might use that. I'm going to do a different video for tomorrow, but the video after that, I might do like a gold glitter Glam or something. I'll figure out what I'm gonna call it. But tomorrow's video, I think I want to do a sunset ombre smoky eye, and I think I'm gonna add a wing liner, do a nude lip, you know. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have fun with that. But I actually really like this red lip because it's like a true red, and it's like kind of like a blue base.
I don't know, it's different, and it looks really good with my pale skin. I know if I post this video tomorrow, my mom's gonna be like, love the red lip. She loves when I do red lips on my channel. A lot of people think I look like her when I do a red lip, but we don't look exactly the same, very similar, but this is basically inspired for her because she loves red lips. Yeah, I really like the Morphe formula. Whenever I do a matte red lip, I like their, I can't even think. I love their liquid matte lipstick. It's really hydrating. It lasts all day long. Like, yeah, it like doesn't even come off. It lasts all day long. It's waterproof. This would look great if you were a bride. I think this is like a pretty standard look I do on my channel, and I love it. And I love I did a different highlight. I just used the Becca highlights. I haven't used just Becca highlights in a really long time. And I forgot how much I love that NARS bronzer and that NARS organism. Yes, honey! Yes! I don't know, I kind of like that I used some old school stuff I haven't done in a really long time. So I'm happy with that. Yeah, and I love this look because it's still, it's a little smoky on the outer corner. A lot of runway looks, models, like they, I've seen models have this look, and it's just like a perfect go-to smoky eye, and I love it. And I love that I didn't use a black liner in my waterline. I used a cream liner, and just kind of ties the whole look together. I look very like glam, like Marilyn Monroe. Like this is definitely inspiration for me. Anyways, you guys, it's about 8 o'clock right now. I'm going to try to do my hair. My hair feels beautiful. I'm dry yesterday, but whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had so much fun. It's so fucking hot in my fucking apartment. It's like crazy. It's crazy up in here, y'all. Yeah, I just wanted to do something different on my channel. Have you noticed, like, on my channel, I don't like to do the same look in a row. I'm just doing something different, so I'm just here. So if you guys have any other requests or any looks that you want to see, I would love to take requests. You guys know I'm here for you, especially in quarantine. I'm not going back to work yet, so I'm just gonna enjoy my time. Yeah, and if you guys can do any of my looks here on my channel, don't forget to thank me. I love what you guys do and get inspired, and I get inspired with you back. I love it. Anyways, you guys, I hope you really enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe. I love this. Yeah, I love this look. I can't wait to do the look for tomorrow. I'm gonna do like a different kind of sunset. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this tutorial. Yeah, so I love you, and hopefully you guys aren't getting bored too soon. So hopefully you guys will be home really soon, and you don't get sick. I haven't got sick so far, but also I haven't left the house in like 5 days. But I love you guys so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.